What's up, everybody? It's Helix. I'm playing Star Wars X-Wing Alliance. It's an old game, and I really never got to play this too much when I was younger. I played a lot of Rogue Squadron and a bunch of other games, but X-Wing Alliance, TIE Fighter, X-Wing, X-Wing versus TIE Fighter, I had friends that played them, so I kind of know how they go, but I really missed out on these, and I know that they are critically acclaimed and fan favorites. And being the Star Wars fan I am, I feel like I'm really missing out. So this isn't just a let's play this game I know so well and do everything perfectly. This is going to be me experiencing it for the first time ever and hopefully not embarrassing myself and sucking at it. We will see how many tries these missions take and how much trouble I have figuring out the controls. I hear they can be pretty daunting on the keyboard if you haven't played it before. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. There's not going to be a whole lot of commentary because I'm flying with a joystick here and I don't have my push to talk queued up right. But if I was sitting there talking while flying at the same time, I probably wouldn't be too focused. So let's get started. So we're going to go over here to my mail because I saw that blinking earlier and I didn't mean to click it. So this looks like my older brother messaging me if you need help. Hey, little brother, now that you've hooked up for email, don't think you're too macho to ask for help when you need it. In other words, don't be like your brother, Eamon. I'm always here. And that's followed by a message from Eamon. Okay, Hotshot, I've been waiting for you to get behind the stick. Now you're really going to grow up fast. It's nasty space out there, kid, but with a little practice, you'll increase your odds of survival. By the time you get this message, I'll already be on my way back home to take you for a couple of introductory runs. An Alliance net. The largest network service in the galaxy. To solve problems, alliance.reb. To create problems, contact Vader and AMP. I like it. I like it a lot. This kind of detail. I want this in future Star Wars games. I'm recording this series a couple days after the Star Wars Battlefront Electronic Arts beta went live. I like the game. It's fun. Contrary to how many feel about it, I think it's just as good as the original Battlefront games, if not a little better, and I definitely played both of those from launch a lot. But this kind of detail, this little lore building backside to games with all the flavor text and character building, I like this, and I hope that we don't lose this in Star Wars games to come. EA has got a mixed track record. So this droid was telling me earlier that he's got something exciting to show me if I click on his holo projector. So let's see what he's got.
You've spent enough time playing simulator games that Dad is convinced it's time to put you to work. He asked me to take you on a delivery run to Harlequin Station. We've got a couple of cargo canisters to transport there, and they have some supplies we'll be picking up to bring back. We'll be using the YT-1300s. I'm taking the Silu. You can fly the Sabra. MK will accompany you as your co-pilot. All you have to do is follow me and do what I do. We're picking up fuel cells and coolant. Dad was pretty emphatic about not forgetting the coolant. It's for the Otana. If everything goes smoothly, you'll be working solo in no time.
You will fly the Sabra, one of our family's modified Corellian YT-1300 transports. Errand will fly an identical ship, the Silu. Each of you is to pick up a cargo canister of supplies. The cargo canisters are to be delivered to Harlequin Station. There you will pick up some fuel cells, while Errand picks up a container of coolant. These supplies are to be brought back to Azamine home base. I will be your co-pilot, and Errand will be in overall command. So do exactly as she says.
Oh god, I'm intimidated already. Okay. So I've got my Xbox 360 controller hooked up. Oh wow. Oh, this is wonderful. Oh my god. Alright. So I'm in the cockpit of a YT-1300. I really am. Okay. What do the keys do? Okay, 9 is like an external view. Looks like the numbered keys are different views. Hey, I look an awful lot like a young Han Solo. Interesting. Okay. Got like a maintenance droid or something there. This is from like on the pad. This is awesome. All right. So, I have arrow key functionality, but I don't have my joystick or controller functionality. May have to troubleshoot this and come back in a second if this doesn't work, because I don't think flying with the keyboard is going to be the best way to play this. But, find out! Okay. Pick up cargo canister, send button. Alright, well, for now, let's go ahead and launch.
I'll take the one on the right, and you take the one on the left. Press
okay.
T to target the first cargo canister.
Go down to a crawl as you come in above it.
I'm back, and I've definitely solved the resolution with the X-Wing Alliance resolution patcher. So now I need to figure out what all my controls are. Use the number keys for an external view, the cursor keys, and enter to navigate the menu. And I have basic functionality with the... I'm going to see what the different buttons on my controller do. Hopefully I don't shoot anything I shouldn't.
Initiate automatic pickup. Shift P. When you are within 0.2 clicks.
Okay, so when I do that pickup maneuver, I need to have it targeted. So I think that's going to be the X key or the X button on my controller, but we'll find out. Okay, so I almost shot the payload, but I figured out how to do it. It's B, not X. All right, so let's get over it and... docked with precious cargo. Okay, now.
Great. Now target the nav buoy and key and head toward it. Once you're within 0.5 clicks of the buoy, we can make the jump.
So, Errand, your friend Olin hasn't been around lately. Why?
I didn't want to say, but he's joined the rebellion as a pilot.
Really? Wow. We should do that. I bet one of us could be the next Luke Skywalker.
Who?
You know, the guy in the bootleg holo Olin showed us. The guy who took out the Death Star at Yavin.
Well, I hate to rain on your parade, MK, but I don't think the Alliance is accepting droids as pilots. Hit the spacebar to initiate the hyperdrive.
Alright, that was really satisfying.
Here we are at Harlequin Station. Let's deliver the supplies.
Hello, Azami Transports. Thanks for the quick service. Please deliver the cargo canisters to the docking platform.
Just watch where Silu drops her canister, then do the same. For delivery, you must engage the auto-docking procedure.
They sound like something out of Pinky and the Brain, or some kind of cartoon character like that. All right.
Approach to within one click of the station and press Shift D.
Now drop XI-1 next to XI-2 and we'll get what we came for.
Okay, Shift D Delta for docking. Here we go.
Hey,
Incoming vessels are on an attack vector.
It looks like the newcomers
pirates?
In trouble.
System patrol craft Cord is abandoning us. They must have been bought off. Azamine Transport, we request your assistance.
Harlequin Station, what can we do?
These Baraxo have been threatening us for a while. I didn't think they had the guts to try something like this. I am sure they were not expecting a fight. If you move to intercept, they'll probably back off.
They have activated their weapon targeting systems.
I'm not sure we should get involved.
I say we fight. We can run rings around any Varaxo pilot.
Dad's been trying to reach an understanding with the Varaxo.
Someone needs to tell the Varaxo then. They are attacking us.
All right, I'm convinced. Let's teach them some manners.
What do you, Azamine fools, think you're doing? This is a private matter you do well to stay out of.
Well, we're involved now. I'd back off if I were you.
Hey, hey! Attacking craft! Dead ahead!
You won't get away with this. We'll be back.
Be grateful we're letting you go, and do yourself a favor. Ease up, Ace. Let them go. I think they got the message. Don't let us catch you around here again.
Looks like we have them on the run. We are victorious!
Don't gloat. The smart thing was to avoid a fight. Let's just get home safely and report this to Uncle Anton.
Thank you for your help. We owe you a very big favor.
G2 and I-3 are the containers we want. We must go get them.
I've got the coolant.
Did I miss it? Was it over here by the other landing platform? No? What am I looking for? Here we go. Okay, so she's got Sheet 2, and I need Pyth. Alright, Pyth 3, where are you? Oh, you know what? I'm so stupid. It's probably one of these big containers out here. Yep. Alright, let's go grab some.
We have the fuel cells.
Target the nav buoy and let's head home. So long, Harlequin Station.
My camera look controls are just a bit janky. Oh, here we go. Home sweet home. Looks like somebody just got back at the same time as us.
Good work! You're clearly ready to end on transport operations.
I'm not so bad that I can't complete the first mission. Wow, that is turning on a dime. Holy. Alright. It's gonna take some getting used to. My flight stick is a bit sensitive, and so steering something like an A-wing might be a bit difficult in combat, but we'll find out. Had all my objectives on the right. How do you inspect? Did I get the bonus? It looks like I got the bonus inspecting the PES NKDU. Maybe that was when I targeted it and flew close enough? Anyway, let's head to debrief.
Well done. I think Dad will have to agree you're ready to go to work. That mix-up with the Varaxo was an unpleasant surprise and a reminder that you have to be prepared to fight now and then. Harlequin Station's director owes us big time.
That is a nice souvenir you picked up in the last mission.
Presented to you by the appreciative inhabitants of Harlequin Station for your combat assistance against attacking forces. Nice. That's quite the gift.
Great job, Ace! We have earned another chance to show what we can do. This time with Eman.
Eman has something. What do I have in my mail? First to last. Pass it on. What's up, Ace? I'm sure your sister told you I joined the Rebellion. She wasn't too happy about the infrequency of leave time I get. What can I say? Anyway, I want to keep an eye on her. I want you to keep an eye on her for me. Errands slicing can get her into trouble with the Empire. I appreciate it, Ace. And grab as many hours as you can behind the stick. You can always use another good fighter pilot. Well, that's what I plan on doing. Key to the station. The residents of Harlequin Station wish to express their sincere appreciation and gratitude for your heroic efforts in the protection of our station. We hope that the key to our station was received in excellent condition. This key will allow you access to our station's finest accommodations and entertainment services. We look forward to its usage whenever you're in the vicinity. I like it. I've got a home away from home now. So Thomas Asmund, is this Dad? It appears that certain records for our cargo storage areas are either missing or misplaced. Errand is currently working on the problem, but any assistance from all of us would surely speed up the process. Errand will fill you in on any pertinent details. In the meantime, double scan every entry you make into the database to avoid further losses. See you all soon. Tomas. I haven't set foot in the combat sim yet, and I don't have a tour of duty. I guess that's when I joined the Rebellion. Alright, let's see what's up next.
Alright, Ace. Thanks to that little scrap you and Errand got yourselves into with the Varaxo, Uncle Anton wants me to make sure you know how to stay alive when the shooting starts. Your instincts served you well at Harlequin Station. It's evident you've learned something useful from all those space combat sims you're always playing. But now, it's for real. And you can't rely on just instincts and sim experiences. I guess the most important thing to remember is that a YT-1300 isn't a starfighter. For transport, it is fast, light, and maneuverable, but you wouldn't want to take on an Imperial TIE fighter in it. The fact of the matter is, you're better off avoiding trouble in the first place, rather than trying to fight your way out after you've gotten into it. I'm going to run you through some simple targeting exercises, then we'll fly off to an old debris field. It'll be easier than shooting Minox off a power cable. I'll program some drones to liven things up a bit.
We will fly the Sabra again, with yours truly as pilot, and you occupying the gun turret. Iman will be flying the Andrasta, his personally customized Kuat Systems Engineering Fire Spray class patrol craft. We will use drones to help you familiarize yourself with the targeting and sensor systems, and the associated displays available in the gun turret. As soon as you're ready, Iman will lead the way to a debris field, where you can practice your gunnery skills. This is going to be great! We will fly the Sabra again, with yours truly as pilot.
Alright, let's go blow some stuff up. I don't know if I trust a droid as a pilot, or maybe I do, maybe I should. it.
All right, MK. Try not to hit anything in your way out.
Sir, my flight record is quite unblemished.
I know. I'm just rousing you a little. Hope you're enjoying the ride in the gunner's turret, little brother. Alright, MK. Park your ship above that rendezvous buoy.
Eamon will drop off a few drones while he explains.
Target the drone, then examine the CMD and sensor displays. The CMD identifies the target and displays critical target data. The sensor displays allow you to track all nearby objects. Just remember, the bracketed dot is what you have targeted. The colors identify friend from foe, neutral and unknown. Purple is family, blue is neutral, presumed friendly. Red designates an Imperial vessel, and green is a rebel craft. Gold as any other aggressor or unknown that is presumed hostile. So what do you say, you and I just get straight to the shooting?
Go ahead and shoot all the drones.
Way to stick it to them. Very impressive.
Blast everything in sight. Target the nearest piece of junk and destroy it. That's enough of a head start. Let me show you how it's done.
You
I'm talking about. Now we're getting somewhere. Ancient history. I'm under attack. That's gonna hurt. We crushed them. Mess with the best, die like the rest. Hey, let's celebrate. I'll buy you a drink at Denari's Casino.
Denari's Casino? That place has a colorful reputation.
Follow me, MK. You have the coordinates. Hey! Enemy in range!
Hey, does that pursuer look familiar?
Yeah, they chased that ship away from Harlequin Station.
Yeah, they shot at you, didn't they? Let's go show them what we think of that. Contrasta, you've just worn out your welcome. Cease fire at once. Settle your disputes elsewhere. Acknowledged. We were just leaving. Sorry, little brother. We'll get that drink some other time.
Oh, thanks, brother. You just possibly destroyed our ship. Are we? Oh, we have to hit space. Never mind.
Not too shabby. You've demonstrated pretty decent gunnery skills in the good old YT-1300. I guess we can trust you with some of the riskier jobs that sometimes come our way. You might actually be useful the next time some stinking group of pirates tries to jump one of our ships.
I really can't put a finger on that accent. I thought it was Scottish, and it's just, it's bad. Alright, let's go back to crew quarters.
That is a nice souvenir you picked up in the last mission.
Brother makes a promise, he keeps it. This chit will get you to celebration that celebration drink in Denari's Casino. Great. I better be able to spend it. What are these? Are these other things? They're just... This whole thing is the chip.
By the sounds of it, we had better help out Errand quickly. Listen to this.
Listen to what? I gotta check my mail first, though. Carmen Viraxo. As it means, it is senseless to continue competing with us. Take your business elsewhere while you still have one. The Viraxo will make you this generous offer. Keep all Azamine ships out of Viraxo space and away from Viraxo customers, and we will not crush you like tiny insects. Oh, that's a challenge. And Rita Murr. I've been searching a long time for you, Ace. That is, if you are the Ace I dated back at Luxiar 7. If you are my Ace from Luxiar 7, then I have just one thing to say to you. Drop dead, you louse. P.S. If I have the wrong Ace, please disregard. Well... I have no idea about that. I don't remember a planet called Luxiar 7. Wink, wink.
Hey, little brother. I need your help. Before Dad and Galen left, Dad gave me permission to work on a new security code system for our cargo storage area records. I figured out a new system that'll work really well, but I managed to trash the old one completely before updating it. Now I have to rebuild the database. To do that, I need to go to each of the affected storage areas and scan every container. With your help, we can get it done twice as fast. And if we do it right away, we can be back before Uncle Anton even realizes we're gone.
Errand has asked your assistance in restoring the records database she accidentally trashed. I will be your co-pilot in the Sabra, and she will fly the seal. We will fly together to the three affected cargo storage areas. We must inspect all cargo containers in each area, then return home.
Interesting, I can install countermeasures. I've got chaff and flares. Can I do both? No? Okay, well, we'll run with chaff for now. I guess that means we are at risk of being attacked by the Viraxos. Jealous kids.
Target the nav buoy and we'll be on our way. Type G's, you take the type I's. Eamon says you did pretty well with the weapons training. That's great, because things have been heating up out here. Since the rebels destroyed the Empire's Death Star at Yavin. In the chaos of war, some people are sure to take advantage. As a case in point, our competition with the Viraxo. That incident at Harlequin Station is just the beginning. Yeah, Uncle Anton says Carmen Viraxo is some sort of petty crime lord. And that he's been trying to steal business from us. There's even a rumor that he's blackmailed an Imperial officer. We're going to have to be very careful out here. Thank you. through here. Let's go on to the second area.
Attempting to steal from us. We should make sure they do not come back. Primary target update. They have started their docking operation. Report on primary target. They have completed their docking operation. Report on primary target. Their shields are up. Primary target update. Their hull is heavily damaged. They have been destroyed. That's gonna teach them some manners. Let us do what we came to do. We will report this later.
You take the tanks. I'll take the Type J containers.
What you up to over there, sister? I'm all done over here.
Great. Just one more area to go.
Thank you.
Sounds like pirates to me.
We've got trouble. An unidentified ship is in the cargo area.
Hey, hey! You better shake that bandit off your stick!
And it has escort! We must get them!
Unidentified ship, you're trespassing. State your business.
They're not responding. Assume they are hostile. Looks like they are bugging out, Errands.
Like
should
these,
we stop them?
Competitors' ships.
Yeah, if we can. We need to know what's going on here.
It is the Enkidu again. That is a Varaxone ship. Primary target update. They are aborting their mission. Report on primary target. They are under attack. You have attacked a friendly craft! The cowards have gotten away.
Well, let's finish what we came here to do. We'll report this to Uncle Anton as soon as we get back. You take the spears, I'll take the boxes. I guess our visitors were up to no good. Yeah, and you realize this storage area has been compromised.
That means we will have to move all these containers.
Let's hurry up and finish, then we'll return home. Okay, we're done. Let's go home.
Should we leave that container of spice here?
I guess we ought to bring it home with us. I'll pick it up. All we need now is to get caught by a random Imperial patrol.
Don't say that.
Thanks a lot, little brother. I owe you one. Now let's go tell Uncle Anton about what we saw.
Okay, if this is what a docking procedure looks like... Oh my god, please, what's going on? Abort docking procedure?
You did well. Aaron was grateful for your help. It certainly sped up the process of restoring the storage container database. And it was really lucky we were there to help her deal with those interlopers. Just think. Raiders in one cargo area, and Miraxo troublemakers at another. This all means the security of our storage areas has been compromised. We will have to relocate all those containers. The discovery of contraband spice in one of those containers was a shock. The Miraxo sure do play dirty. Aaron is filling in Uncle Anton, and we will see what he says. But I will bet he figures out a way to get back at them. That is a nice souvenir you picked up in the last mission.
The skirmish souvenir was found floating in the debris after you tangled with space pirates. The clan's symbol is unknown, probably mercenaries.
Uh-oh. Uncle Anton is not very happy with us. I had better turn the volume down on this one.
Between you and I, I've not copied this message to any other members of the family because I did not want to cause unnecessary alarm. Errand worries too much already, and Eamon is too hot-headed, so it's you, young brother. This may be nothing at all, but I've had a terrible gut feeling lately. I think we Azamines should stay extra alert while we're out on cargo runs. Influence the others to try to fly in pairs, okay? Just be safe. Let's hope it's merely lack of sleep. Oh boy, the Force is communicating with him. I've been making a few short trips into Smuggler's Run. Galen will be back with me. The rest of you watch the fort and stick together. Be back soon. Oh boy. What do we have to hear from Father?
But you are surrendering now.
Hey, hey! Watch out for those turbo lasers!
Guess again, scumbag. Errand, you and I have a firepower to take on that gunship. Which means you'll have to take out those so-called taxis.
I'm under attack! Defensive fire is too intense. We gotta back off.
What's your status, Dad?
You have attacked a friendly craft!
Those technicians are disabling the pursuit.